Katie, the Creative and Performing Arts Prefect for 2023, and this is lovely Laura, who is the Creative and Performing Arts Prefect for the Junior School of 2023. Starry Night is always one of the highlights on the PLC calendar, and we will be commencing our evening here and moving into the Ad Astra Centre after a short intermission. As you just heard, that was our wonderful PLC Orchestra, and the PLC Orchestra consists of the PLC Jazz Band and PLC Senior Strings combined, who have just performed a lovely medley of three classic James Bond tunes: the James Bond theme song from Monty Norman, Your Eyes Only by Bill Conti, and Live and Let Die by Paul McCartney and Linda McCartney. Every year, our Year 7 cohort begin the adventure of learning wind and brass instruments as part of the class program. Many girls go on to pursue playing their instrument for many years, joining the Jazz Band, AYO programs, enrolling in the elective music classes, studying music in the HSC, competing in Stanford Solos, and competing AMEB exams. Nearly half of the girls in Jazz Band and the wind players in the orchestra started playing their instruments in the Year 7 instrumental program. Tonight we will be treated to the 2023 cohort performing Flight of Banshee, conducted by Paul Marshall, who is head of winds at the New England Conservatorium of Music. Could you please make them feel welcome? You are in a real treat for. Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake is renowned for its exquisite melodies and iconic reoccurring theme. Tonight you will have a fully immersive experience capturing the essence of the enchanted swan through the senior strings, with Jenna Marquardt playing the tragic human Odette. Much of the choreography you will see is the iconic choreography of Odette's solo of the Dying Swan, danced beautifully tonight to the iconic theme song of Swan Lake. Could you please make them all feel welcome? Allegro, performed by the Senior String Ensemble, is the fourth movement of the Concerto Opus 6, No. 1 in G major by the German Baroque composer George Frederick Handel. This arrangement is written in a fugal contrapuntal style, where each section is given important melodic material which is traded back and forth. Teo Brown will be leading the ensemble in true chamber music style with Mrs. Fares Wu supporting the viola section. Could you please make them welcome? HSC students completed their practical examinations 3 weeks ago and performed this work for their solo core performance dance. Tonight you will see it as a group dance. Earlier in the year, this group performed in the New England Dance Stepford, winning the section with their version of Center Stage, followed by a close second with Byrne from Hamilton. For the last time together, please welcome the HSC Dance Cohort of 2023.
Thank you. for a short intermission and moving into the Astra Arts Centre, we are going to give you a sneak peek into one of our musical numbers in our upcoming school musical, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Closing the first act, It Must Be Believed to Be Seen, features most members of our 50-strong cast. India Smith and Taya Catterall play Willy Wonka, and Ali Blackrag plays Charlie Bucket. Be prepared to be transported to the factory gates of Wonka's Chocolate Factory with reporters and golden ticket winners. Tickets go on sale for our show next week. Woo, right? Our show is running from October the 26th to the 28th, week 3 next term. It's not far away, but so don't miss out. They will go like Wonka's double fudge mellow delight chocolate bars. Please make the cast of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory welcome.
Hello everyone, and thank you for coming for the second half of the evening. So if everyone could just settle down. just an announcement for upstairs. If you'd like to use those little red chairs just to give your back a bit more support, you're welcome to use those as well. So now I will hand it over to our Junior School Creative Arts Prefect, Laura, to announce our next item.
Silver Strings have been working very hard this term on their ensemble playing, and have learnt how to use the bow to play fancy fast notes in their piece, Stew Pot Hop. They hope you will enjoy their piece as much as they enjoy playing it.
Thank you.
The K-2 choir will now perform two short pieces for you, Moon So Round and Yellow by Colin Brumby and Oh Lovely Mud by Michelle Atherton, which is a hilarious piece about all these farm animals jumping, rolling and paddling in the mud and then needing to be washed by the farmer.
Thank you.
Well, thank you to our lovely and adorable Cater 2 choir. Next up, from our youngest singers to our most experienced singers, Bel Canto Voices is an auditioned vocal ensemble from year 7 to 12. Tonight they will be performing Salut Printemps by Debussy. This piece is a beautiful welcome to spring with a lush piano accompaniment by Mr. Dunham and stunning vocal harmonies. Have a listen and see how many spring images are conjured up. This piece also features the dulcet tones of our soloists, Binity Vathana, Lauren Williams, and Kushi Ayala. Please enjoy.
Thank you. by Brian Ogleson. This work has a vibrant, optimistic feel. One of the standout features of this composition is found in the treatment of the lyric theme, which explodes into a triumphant ending, creating a sense of anticipation and drama. Let's welcome our junior school string players.
Holding those you cherish close and is dedicated to all the girls' loved ones. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
7 drama, we carefully look at the social aspects of growing up, learning about relationships, language, and how to understand empathy. The Red Tree by Sean Tan is a visually stunning picture book that takes us on a journey of loneliness, hope, and resilience. In drama class, we have explored this story, creating frozen moments of poignant sections of the picture book, where a little girl who struggles to see hope finally sees that it was all there all along. She just needed to look for it. In this piece by Lily, Poppy, Grace, Izzy, and Sabella, the red hat is symbolic of hope. Please make them feel welcome. Jojo is a little who person living on that speck of dust, and also has been called a liar, claiming there are bigger people than themselves living outside their planet, the speck of dust. This song is about sticking to your guns and doing what's right, even though it may be hard and you might be alone in the universe. Thank you.
is Latin for weeping and tearful. The short movement forms part of the Requiem Mass in D minor by Mozart. Mozart was on his deathbed as he wrote this. The legend states that the first bar, 8 bars of this movement are the very last notes he wrote in his life. He had a draft for the remainder of the movement, but the work was completed by Susma. Mozart reflected deeply on death and the meaning of life. The Requiem Mass is one of Mozart's most profound and deeply moving works. Please would you welcome the senior choir. Herself doing her HSC major work, which was put performance for her this year in drama. She chose a piece called The Story of Hope, which is from a play called Almost Maine. The Story of Hope details the journey of the young character, Hope, and her wish to make amends with her ex-partner after previously fleeting before answering an important question he asked her. To her surprise, her ex no longer lives there, but rather another young man is the new tenant. Her reaction provokes her to anxiously ramble, describing her current motivations to a complete stranger. You. Katie's embodiment of this character is exemplary. We hope you enjoy it.
I know this isn't going to be very easy, but I was out there, all alone in the world, and I got so scared, because all I could think about was how I had no place in this world. But then, out of nowhere, I realized that there was one place I did have, and that was with you. So I flew. I took a taxi to get here. I just had to come see you. Thank God you're... I'm sorry. This is the house. Does Daniel Harding live here? I'm looking for a Daniel Harding. Yeah, Daniel Harding. Do you know him? He lives here. Oh, okay, he doesn't, does he? I'm so sorry. I'm so embarrassed. Who is this woman and what is she doing here? I honestly thought he'd be here. I always thought he'd be here. Always. Do you know him? tall guy, big tall guy. I play basketball, always in Main Center. Hockey, too. Yeah, do you know him? I'm so sorry. I know that was a horrible question to ask someone who lives in a small town. As if everybody in small towns knows everybody else. I'm so sorry to have bothered you. I was just so sure. When his parents passed away, he kept the house. I heard. He lived here. He stayed here. I thought. He was one of the ones who stayed. I didn't stay. I went away. Yeah, and I guess he did too. I never thought he would. I guess I lost track. You've got to hold on to people, or you lose them. I wish there was somewhere you could keep them. When you need them. Ah, there he is. Perfect. Oh, boy, it's cold. I forgot. The last time I saw him, he asked me a very important question. and I didn't answer him. And that's just not a very nice thing to do to a person. He asked me to marry him. He didn't answer him. That's why I'm here. To answer him. I mean, I didn't answer him at the time because I didn't have an answer. I mean, I was leaving for college, and right as I'm about to go off into the world and explore my hopes and dreams, he asks me, "Will you marry me?" I mean, come on, what was I supposed to do? I told him I'd have to think about it, that I'd think it overnight and be back before the sun came up with an answer. And I left him. Left him standing right there. And then I didn't come back before the sun came up with an answer or at all. And I guess it's kind of like giving someone a little less air to breathe. Every day. Until they die. Anyway. Thank you. I'm so sorry to have bothered you. I was just out there alone and I realized what I'd done. Wait. You just called me Hope. How did you know my name?
Remarkable, isn't she? So Katie did that for her HSE major work a few weeks ago, and along with lots of other HSE students who performed monologues as well. Unfortunately, we can't see all of them. Just had to see our creative arts prefect tonight. Next, we have the cello ensemble. The Webster Scherzo is a well-known work for solo cello, made famous for young cellists in Suzuki Book 3 for cello. This arrangement is written by Rick Mooney for four cellos. Bridie O'Neill from U10 will be playing the solo cello part this evening. Please, would you make them welcome?
Thank you. Thank you.
cappella is a challenging form of music as each singer is required to hold their individual melody, blending with the voices around them, all of which is done without the aid of any accompanying instruments. This vocal group is full of passionate and eager singers, and tonight they will be performing an arrangement of Royals by Lord. Could you please make them feel welcome? Bohemian Rhapsody is possibly the most iconic work of Queen. This 1970s progressive rock classic, written by Freddie Mercury, pushes the boundaries of rock music with multiple sections, including a ballad, an operatic section, a hard rock section. Tonight, the Stage 5 elective music class will perform a vocal arrangement of this work in a three-part harmony, accompanied by Stephanie Blake on piano. Could you please make them welcome?
Thank you.
This will be our final item for the night. Before I hand over to Katie, just to mention, we unfortunately will not be able to see the HSC group performance with Mackenzie, Fifi, Serafina and Gabby tonight. It was going to highlight your evening. Unfortunately, one of our members of the group cannot speak today. So that's a bit tricky for a 10 to 12 minute drama piece, isn't it? So I think it's a bit more important that she recovers because her HSC music exam is on Monday. So she is on strict instructions to not talk at all, to not whisper, to not do anything. Fifi and Berger. So she needs to get well for Monday. So we're not going to be having that performance, but we will have the jazz ensemble, and I'll hand over to Katie to announce that one.
So the PLC Jazz Band is the natural continuation of the Year 7 WIND program. As the ability of our students develops, they are invited to join the Jazz Band, demonstrating what the pathway out of this class-based program and into ensemble membership and private lessons can look like. This group has got so much swagger and plays contemporary tunes such as Isn't She Lovely, Ain't No Mountain High Enough, Billie Jean, and tonight they will be bringing you a classic, Feel It Still. If you notice your feet tapping, just go with it. Please welcome them.
Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of our evening of creative performing arts. And I just like to I felt it was a really great show, and the girls just carried it, and many of the girls are doing performance after performance. I think we should give another round of applause for all the amazing. So putting on a show like this, we've got a really cohesive team. So at first, I'd like to just thank Joe, because we just worked. It's just great, and I really love watching. We had the dance item. We had the combined strings and dance item, which was actually Li Ling Chen's idea. But it was just magic to see that coming together of the disciplines, and we also see that in the production, Charlie, as well. So we've got a list of people here to thank, so we should launch straight into it.
Let's launch straight in. So I guess, I have to say thank you to Matthew, don't I? No, it really is such a blessing to be able to work with such a genius as Matthew, and I feel very blessed to be able to do that. We are a great team and we work really well together. So our first person that we want to thank you, and just her team, is Vanessa Arundel. Thank you so much, Vanessa, you and your team, for being able to put on such a wonderful display of audience, people who I knew when to come and the right place to come. And also to Mel Killen, I don't know if you're still here. I think she started with us 2 weeks ago. Baptism of Fire. Welcome to PLC. I think she has done 4 or 5 programs for different events already in the time that she's been here because of all of the things, and she's done a marvellous job. So thank you to Vanessa and her team. Also, huge thank you to all of the staff who volunteered to help us tonight. You know who you are. The people who are here, Greg here with us, stage manager, and all of the people. I won't mention everyone just in case I don't, in case I forget people. But just moving instruments, helping with chatting, helping with our student supervision with the junior school teachers especially. So thank you to all of the staff helpers.
And I'd really like to thank my music team. We've just got a fantastic team with a really great diversity of skills. So, Connie, where are you here, Connie? Come on out if you're here. And Mr. Giacometti, Sam Giacometti. I think you've witnessed their wizardry with the girls tonight, so it's amazing. We've also got an extended team with Li Ling Chen over here and Paul Marshall, who is conducting the band, who I work really closely with the program. And, of course, our string team. So we welcome Georgie Austinfield to our team this year with the juniors. She's doing a fantastic job. You can see the silver strings is just growing, and all the girls in stage one just want to be in the group. They're all just trying to get into the music room at lunchtime. We can't keep them. We have to block the doors. So, and Joanna, of course, who's leading that team, and Rob Jackson, so to our string players.
But of course, none of this can happen without you. So parents, thank you so much. We absolutely understand the encouragement of practicing their instruments, of learning their lines for drama, of rehearsing for dance, for dropping them at all times of the day and night for rehearsals and the extra rehearsals. So thank you to you for all of your hard work with raising your girls so beautifully.
And I'd like to thank, we have some really fine student leaders. So many of our student leaders, they don't have to have a badge to be a fine leader. So while you were enjoying a fabulous concert, behind the scene, it's girls are just helping wherever they could. Like sending off a girl to find, to recruit another group, and moving equipment and running across the music room to get a thing that we might need. So just all the girls. But the leader of our team is Katie Alcorn. Please come forward.
And it's very sad because it's Katie's last starry night. very sad, makes my heart hurt. And also, of course, Laura Butterworth, thank you so much. She has done an absolutely marvellous job. Her first opportunity, her first gig as the Kappa Prefect at Junior School. So well done to Laura. I'm sure that you enjoyed the snacks and the drinks at the start and the interval, so thank you so much to PNF for all that you do and for preparing such wonderful array of surprises and wonderful things that we're able to enjoy, so thank you. Also to our maintenance team, putting all the chairs in right the places. It's all the things that just happen to be there and we don't notice unless they're not there, so we're very thankful that for your work. And also to our IT team, the wonderful Chris and the wonderful Zach, for all that you do for us as well, so thank you.
And just finally, none of this happens without the support of the school executive who have the vision to support Joe and I. And so we're really grateful and we just feel really comfortable working under the executive we've got. We've got a fantastic school executive led by our principal, Nicola Taylor. So for Nicola and the executive team.
So thank you so much for a wonderful night. We hope to see you next Starry Night. I think the next thing on the agenda is the string soiree next term, so we hope you enjoy that. Oh,
Charlie tickets,
don't forget those. The magic will happen on Monday or Tuesday, so keep an eye out. Thank you so much for a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.